Hey everybody, I hope all y'all are doing really, really good. You know, one of my favorite things to do when I have some downtime is to read. You know, I love reading books. And I've always been like that growing up. Usually it could take me a day or a couple days to finish a book, but I really enjoy it for fun and just to learn new things. I really loved the AR club when I was in elementary school to gain points and all that fun stuff. And I remember my last year in fifth grade, I got a certificate for receiving the most highest points throughout the whole school. So I love to read, and one of my favorite books growing up was The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. And if you haven't seen it, I highly recommend that you read the book, or if you don't like to read, you can watch the movie because the movie is really, really awesome. But the book follows four children throughout the book. Their names are Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy. And out of all the four children, I want to focus on one of the middle children, which was Edmund. You know, Edmund was probably one of the most disliked kids in the book, but as a Christian, he is probably one that we can relate to the most. You know, see, Edmund betrays his siblings to side with the evil antagonist in the book, which was the White Witch. She promised Edmund to be king of Narnia and that he would be over his siblings, ruling over his siblings, and he loved that. You know, he was memorized by the White Witch's offers, and Edmund leaves his siblings to join her. And once he arrives to her palace, he quickly finds out that the White Witch was never serious about making him king or anything, and enslaves him. Soon, Edmund is rescued from the White Witch's palace and reunited with his siblings at Aslan's camp. Aslan in the book is a great lion and the creator of Narnia and our hero, our protagonist in the book. And soon after Edmund arrives to the camp, to Aslan's camp, the White Witch arrives to collect Edmund back as a prisoner to be killed. Instead of Edmund being killed, Aslan takes his place willingly to be killed himself. So that night, with all the evil creatures gathered around, Aslan lays his life down for Edmund. And everyone is just so upset about this because Aslan was the one that was supposed to save Narnia. Aslan was the one that was supposed to defeat the White Witch and bring goodness back to the land. So everyone is just so upset about this. But we see the very next day that Aslan is resurrected and defeats the White Witch. And after that, the four children, Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy, are crowned kings and queens of Narnia. And Edmund has his name changed to King Edmund the Just. Guys, the reason I'm talking about this book today, first, I love this book, but because this book is such a beautiful illustration of what Jesus did for us, what Jesus did for us this week. You see, you and I are a lot like Edmund. You know, Edmund betrays everyone for his own selfish desires and finds himself enslaved to the White Witch. Guys, you and I have betrayed God. You and I have fallen away from God, and we are enslaved to this thing called sin. In Romans 3:23, it says, "For all have sinned, have fallen short of the glory of God." Because of sin, guys, because of sin, we have fallen short. Because of sin, there is a barrier between us and God, and we cannot make things right on our own. Just like how Edmund was chained and bound to the White Witch, guys, you and I are chained and bound to sin. And there's nothing we can do on our own to set ourselves free. And we see later on that the White Witch comes to collect Edmund to put him to death. She comes to the camp where he is at and claims him and puts him to death. But we see something else happen. We see something incredible happen. We see Aslan steps in Edmund's place that Aslan sacrifices himself instead of Edmund. He takes Edmund's consequences and places them on himself, and he dies in Edmund's place. Because our betrayal, because of us being enslaved to sin, God, death has a hold on us. In Romans 6:23, it says, "For the wages of sin is death." Sin came with a price, and that price was death. But you and I didn't have to pay this price. You see, in Romans 5:8, it says, "But God demonstrates his own love towards us, that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Guys, while we were still enslaved to sin, while we were still rebels, you know, God still loved us. Even though we were imperfect, God still loved you and God still loved me. And Christ came and died for us while we were still sinners, taking the consequences upon himself, taking our guilt, taking our shame, and putting them upon himself. And Christ died for us on a cross. He allowed himself to be nailed for you and for me in order to set us free. And just like how Aslan didn't stay dead, neither did Christ. Because on the third day after Christ's death, something amazing happened. In Luke 24, 1 through 7, guys, it says this. "Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women went with him and came to the tomb, bringing the spices which they had prepared. But they found the stone had been rolled away from the tomb. Then they went in and they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And it happened, as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them, shining in garments. Then, as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, 'Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how we spoke to you that he was in Galilee, saying the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men and be crucified and risen on the third day.'" Guys, Christ rose victorious over death, rose victorious over sin. Sin does not have a hold on us anymore, and we have been set free by Christ dying for us and rising again. At the end of the book, you see that the four children are crowned kings and queens of Narnia. Edmund had his name changed, and Edmund had become King Edmund the Just. You see, Edmund's wrongs were made right because of Aslan. You and I have been justified in Christ. Our wrongs have been made right. In Romans 5:1, it says, "Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God and the Lord through the Lord Jesus Christ." Guys, Jesus' sacrifice and resurrection has justified you and me. We have been made right in the sight of God. Jesus took all of our wrongs and made them right. And that's why we celebrate Easter this week, because the Savior of the world came and redeemed you and I. Jesus has justified us. And guys, that is what this week is all about. Jesus coming to the earth, taking your wrongs, taking your shame, and placing them upon himself, and dying on the cross for you and me, paying the consequences for you and me. But guys, when Sunday comes, man, Jesus walks out of that grave victorious over death, victorious over sin. And because he did that, you and I have victory over death and sin through Jesus Christ. Because of Jesus' resurrection, we have peace with God once again. Guys, I hope y'all have a great week, and I hope you take time Sunday to reflect on what Jesus did for you, that he died on Friday, but he walked out of that tomb on Sunday. And if you do not know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, guys, you can have peace with God through him. You can be saved through him. There doesn't have to be a barrier between you and God. You don't have to carry that weight of sin and shame on your shoulders anymore. Give it over to Jesus You know that he died for you, but most importantly, know that he rose again in victory, and through him you can be saved. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for our time here today, Lord. We thank you so much for Jesus who came and died in our place, Lord. But most importantly, we are so thankful that he rose again in victory over death and victory over sin. And that's why we celebrate Easter, Jesus' amazing resurrection. God, thank you for all that you do. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Guys, I'll see you next week.